In part 2, chapter 17 of Chinua Achebe's Things Fall Apart, the missionaries have been preaching in the Mbanta marketplace. Now they request land and receive a plot in the evil forest that the villagers believe is filled with sinister forces. The elders, in fact, offered them as much of the evil forest as they'd like, and no one expects them to accept the land. The elders are convinced the missionaries will fail miserably. After the missionaries build their church, the villagers wait for their gods and ancestors to take revenge. The villagers keep waiting for the missionaries to die in the forest, but they don't. And some of the villagers, moved by this, begin to convert. They expect the gods' vengeance to occur within 28 days. When the 28th day passes and nothing happens, the missionaries win a few more converts, including a pregnant woman named Neka. Her previous pregnancies resulted in twins, an abomination in the Igbo faith. Those infants were abandoned to die, and Neka doesn't want to risk the same fate again. Nwoye has been attracted to the missionaries from the beginning, but he dared not go too near them for fear of his father. When Nwoye does go to the church, his cousin sees him and tells Okonkwo. When Nwoye comes home, Okonkwo begins to beat him, but Uchendu steps in and demands the boy's release. Okonkwo releases Nwoye, who walks away, never to return. The leader of the Mbanta church, Mr. Kiaga, blesses Nwoye because he forsakes his father. Nwoye returns to Mwofia, Okonkwo's homeland, to learn skills his father would never dream of teaching him. His conversion is a total rejection of Okonkwo's way of life. Okonkwo, meanwhile, contemplates what has happened with his son, which makes little sense to him. After all, Okonkwo is the roaring flame for his strength and boldness. How can Nwoye be so weak and passive? It then occurs to him that living fire begets cold, impotent ash. Because Nwoye is his son, this is the natural order, and therefore he's powerless to do anything about it. The elders and clan leaders believe they're clever to let the missionaries have land in the evil forest. This will surely mean the missionaries are doomed to failure. The ancestral gods will surely strike them down. Then the clan can reunite and faith will be restored. Yet the church is built and the time of punishment passes. The Igbo gods have failed to banish the intruders. Up to this point, Nwoye has been attracted to the missionaries, but has accepted the tradition of living with his family in Okonkwo's compound. But when Okonkwo beats Nwoye for attending church, Nwoye breaks from his traditional role to exercise his own free will. He returns to the church and decides to enroll at the church school in Umuofia.